Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we're going to be looking at three-way switches for lighting circuits in North America. We're going to look at three different circuit designs depending on if you want the light fitting to be at the beginning, the middle, or the end of the lighting circuit. Now I've included a handy PDF wiring guide for this video with detailed illustrations of each circuit, as well as step-by-step instructions and a part list for all three types. You can keep this guide on your PC or mobile and access them anywhere at any time. Links for that in the video description down below. Now we're covering the theory in this video, but remember electricity is dangerous and can be fatal. You should be qualified and competent before carrying out any electrical work. So how do three-way switches work? If we look at a three-way switch, we have four screw terminals. One is for ground, one is our common terminal, and the other two are our traveler terminals. Inside the switch, we have a track which electricity flows along. This is connected to the switch handle. When we flip the switch handle, the track will flip between the two traveler terminals. This will change the path electricity can take, and that's how we will control the light. The first circuit we're going to look at is where the light fitting is last in the circuit. For this circuit, we're going to need the following parts: some 3-wire cable, some 2-wire cable, 4-wire connectors, a ceiling box, a light fitting, 2 3-way switches, and 2 switch boxes. For the incoming power supply, we take the black hot wire and connect this into the common terminal of switch 1. We then run the black traveler wire from the left traveler terminal of switch 1 and take this over to the left traveler terminal of switch 2. Then we run the black hot wire from the common terminal of switch 2 over to the ceiling box and into the light fitting. Then we take the red traveler wire and run that from the right-hand traveler terminal of switch 1 and take this over to the right traveler terminal of switch 2. Now for the incoming neutral, we run that into the wire connector which would sit within the switch box for switch 1. We then connect from this wire connector and run the white wire to a wire connector in switch box 2. Then we run the final white wire from the wire terminal of switch 2 and take this over through the ceiling box and onto the light fitting which will complete the circuit. To provide some safety, we run a ground wire from the incoming supplier and connect this into a wire connector within switch box 1. Then we run a ground wire from the ground terminal of switch 1 and connect this to the ground wire connector. We connect the next ground wire between the wire connector of switch box 1 and the wire connector in switch box 2. Then we run a ground wire from switch box 2 to the ground wire connector also. Finally, as the ceiling box is metal, we will run a ground wire from the ground screw in the box and connect this to the ground wire connector in switch box 2. So there we have a complete circuit with a 2-wire cable on the incoming power supply, a 3-wire cable between the two switches, and another 2-wire cable from switch 2 over to the light fitting. Now if we power this circuit, we see that electricity comes in through the hot wire and passes across switch 1 and along the black traveler wire to switch 2. But switch 2 is in the up position, so the circuit is broken and the light is off. When we flip switch 2, the tracks change direction and electricity can now flow across switch 2, through the light and back along the neutral wire. If we were to flip switch 1, the electricity can now flow across switch 1 and into the red traveler wire, but it stops at switch 2 as the tracks are disconnected. But by flipping switch 2, we again complete the circuit. The next circuit we'll look at is where the light fitting is between the two switches. For this circuit, we'll need some 2 and 3 wire cable, 5 wire connectors, a ceiling box, a light fitting, 2 3-way switches, and some black electrical tape. So from the incoming power supply, we will connect the black hot wire to the common terminal of switch number 1. Then we run the black traveler wire from the left traveler terminal of switch 1 and take this over to the wire connector in the ceiling box. Then we run another black wire from the wire connector and connect this into the left traveler terminal of switch 2. Then we run the red traveler wire from the right traveler terminal of switch 1 and connect this to the wire connector in the ceiling box. Then we run another red wire from the wire connector and connect this to the right traveler terminal of switch 2. Now we bring our neutral wire in from the incoming supply and connect that into a wire connector within switch box 1. Then we run another neutral wire and run this from the wire connector through the ceiling box and connect it into the light fitting. Then we run a third white wire from the other light fitting terminal and we run this to the common terminal of switch number 2. We must mark both ends of this wire with black electrical tape to warn that it is hot. Now to make the circuit safe, we bring our ground wire into the wire connector. Then we connect to the ground terminal of switch 1 and into the wire connector. Then we run another ground wire from the wire connector and bring this to the wire connector within the ceiling box. As the ceiling box is made of metal, we will need to connect this to ground also. Then finally, we want to ground switch too, so we run a ground wire from the ground terminal and bring that over to the ground wire connector within the ceiling box. So there we go, a complete circuit where we have a two-wire cable on the incoming supply into switch box 1, then between both switches 1 and 2 and the light fitting, we have three-wire cable. Now if we power this circuit, we see that electricity can flow through the hot, across switch 1, through the ceiling box, and to the terminal of switch 2. But the circuit is broken at switch 2, so the light is off. When we flip switch 2, electricity can now flow across the switch, through the light, and back through the neutral wire. If we flip switch 1, electricity will again be able to make it to switch 2 by the red traveller, but it can't get across switch 2. But if we flip switch 2, then we complete the circuit and the light will turn on. The final circuit we'll cover is where the light fitting is before the two switches. For this type of circuit, we'll need some 2 and 3 wire cable, a ceiling box, some wire connectors, 2 switch boxes, 2 three-way switches, a light fitting and some black electrical tape. So for this circuit, we'll bring the incoming supply hot black wire into the ceiling box first and connect this into a wire connector. Then we run a white wire from the wire connector and connect this into a wire connector within switch box 1. We must mark both ends of this wire with black electrical tape to warn that it is hot. Then we run another white wire from the wire connector and connect to the common terminal of switch 2, again marking the ends with black electrical tape. Now we run a red traveller wire from the right traveller terminal of switch 2 and connect this to the right traveller terminal of switch number 1. Then we run a black traveller wire between the left traveller terminals of the two switches. From switch 1, we connect a black wire from the common terminal and connect this to the light fitting terminal. Now to complete the circuit, we will bring our incoming neutral and connect this to the other light fitting terminal. To make the circuit safe, we bring our incoming ground wire and connect this to a wire connector within the ceiling box. As the ceiling box is metal, we will need to ground that also using the ground screw. Then we run another ground between this wire connector and another within switch box 1. From there, we will connect the switch ground terminal to the wire connector. And finally, we run a ground wire from the ground terminal of switch 2 and over to the ground wire connector. So there we have a complete circuit with a two-wire cable for the incoming supply into the ceiling box, a two-wire cable to the first switch, and a three-wire cable between the two switches. When we power this circuit, electricity can flow through the hot wire and into the white wire and over to switch 2. Then it travels along the red traveller but stops at switch 1. If we flip switch 2, the electricity can now flow over and across switch 2, then through the light fitting and back through the neutral. When we flip switch 1, electricity can't make it past the switch, so the light is off. If we flip switch 2, the circuit is again complete, so the light will turn on. Okay guys, that's it for this video, but if you want to continue your learning, then check out one of the videos on screen now and I'll catch you there for the next lesson. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and of course, theengineeringmindset.com.